Right now, the subject is Senator Larry Craig, and the panelists are in San Diego, Judge David Young, who preside over a new TV court program bearing his name. It premieres in syndication in September. He's a former circuit court judge in Miami-Dade County, and he's in San Diego to address the 2007 convention of the National Lesbian and Gay Journalists Association. In New York is Randi Rhodes, host of the popular Randi Rhodes Show on Air America. In Portland, Oregon, Lars Larson, talk radio host of the Lars Larson Show. The motto of his show is Right on the Left Coast. And here in Los Angeles, Judge Greg Mathis, presiding over TV's Judge Mathis Show, former Michigan District Court judge. We'll begin right away with the political verdict against Craig has been rather swift and harsh. Republican leaders already calling for his resignation. Here is Senator John McCain in this interview with CNN. Watch.
Pled guilty, and he had the opportunity to plead innocent. So I think he should resign. My opinion is that when you plead guilty to a crime, then you shouldn't serve. And that's not a moral stand. That's not a holier-than-thou. It's just a factual situation. I don't try to judge people, but in this case, it's clear that it was disgraceful.
Judge Young, what do you say?
I agree with the senator. You know, the problem is that he tried to cover it up. That's the reason he needs to resign. When he said that he pled to a lesser charge so it would go away, what does that tell you? You know, it just smacks of hypocrisy, and the man should not be in the United States Senate whatsoever.
Lars Larson, what do you think?
Now he's compounded the crime because he came out yesterday and announced that he didn't really want to plead guilty and that he's not really guilty of anything. That either means he lied to the court or he's lying now to his constituents. He needs to resign, Larry.
Randi Rhodes, what's going on with this? And there's a front page story in the New York Times today about what's hitting Republicans. What do you make of this?
Well, he's a hypocrite, and people don't like hypocrisy. Some people like bigotry, and they practice it regularly. But, you know, hypocrisy just reeks. And, you know, what could I tell you? The guy was in a bathroom. I think that's the most embarrassing part of the story is he was in a bathroom, Larry. I'm a woman. I would rather explode than use a public toilet. You know, it's one of those things. But it does explain in a weird way, you know, why they went after Clinton the way that they did, because apparently Republicans have a problem with sex with women. It's crazy. The list of gay Republicans is longer than the cast of, you know, Rent or A Chorus Line. I wish everybody would stop right. The bigotry and come out and be who you are. And realize that fear and loathing in this country is so 20th century. This is the 21st. You know,
Judge,
stop with the
Judge
bigotry.
Mathis, what do you think?
Well, in terms of the political ramifications, I think it's very deep. Here you have a conservative, family values, right-wing, Christian-loving man who has criticized the gay lifestyle and other so-called liberal lifestyles, and you catch him under the toilet with a man, allegedly. Then you have a few months ago or a year or so ago, Congressman Foley, same type of politics,
right.
Conservative, right-wing, family values. Then you have the leading evangelist, Ted Haggerty, who was also a right-wing political activist who always espoused family values. I'm becoming confused as to what family values they're talking about.
Hold on.
Well, I think I know what family values are. I really do. You know, the whole idea of, you know, a woman called me today, Larry, and she put it so beautifully. She really did. She said, you know, here on the left, we love our religion, but we love our children more. I really think that's where we ought to start the 21st century off.
You know, Lars, do you want to chip
Larry,
in?
Larry, I got to tell you something. This isn't about loving children. This is about two perverts. If you want to bring up Foley, Foley's a pedophile. That's not homosexuality.
You know what? I know Mark Foley. Foley was my congressman. And let me tell you something. Everybody knew Mark Foley was gay.
Yeah,
and
but the only, Randi, and this the only isn't about person, being gay. It's about being attracted. In Foley's
the only,
case,
the
it
only
was
person,
children.
The only person that wouldn't admit that Mark Foley was gay was Mark Foley,
Randi.
Because Mark Foley didn't believe he could get reelected if he admitted who he
Larry,
was.
Randi, let him talk. Randi, let Lars talk.
Yeah. Here's the thing where Randy's wrong. She's trying to draw a parallel between perverted sex in a bathroom and homosexuality. When Republicans do that, they get bashed. But here's Randy saying they're equivalent. They're not. I've
no,
got homosexual
no, no,
friends,
nobody's saying
they
that
don't
they're
go
equivalent.
They don't
and
go
anybody that knows me knows that.
I think you're missing the point. I think you're missing the point. The point is the contradiction between family values and what they espouse and the lifestyle that they ask.
When you say they, are you saying
fully? I'm referring to they. I'm the only gay person on this panel.
I'm referring to they as Craig. I'm referring to they as Haggard. All of them espouse these family value right wing and they're hypocrites and they're contradictory.
So in other words, Judge Young, hold it. Judge Young, get a word and then Lars.
Yeah, let me get a word edgewise. You know, I appreciate what you all are saying, but the bottom line is, being the only gay person, what this guy did was, in his whole career, has put the gay movement down, put gays and lesbians down, and look what, look what's going on with him. He's in the closet, and he's doing things which give gay people a bad name. If you think that gay people pick up people, which I've heard, at bathrooms and rest stops, you're absolutely insane. It's the policies of this senator that he's voted for time and time again, that he's espoused time and time again, that cause people like him to be in the closet, to go undercover.
Right.
And it is wrong, it is wrong, it is wrong. Did I say his actions are wrong? It's horribly wrong.
All right,
and
more
he should resign.
We'll take a break. More on the so-called sexting senator when we come back. As we go to break, a clip that proves everybody in the country is not taking this story seriously. Stay tuned.
Senator Craig said he made a mistake by pleading guilty.
Oh.
And I was thinking, well, maybe that was your second mistake. And the way I look at it, anybody who spends more than 2 minutes in an airport bathroom is guilty of something.
Oh, for God's sake.
And Senator Craig is married.
Uh-oh.
He's married. Apparently he told his wife, don't worry about having dinner ready for me. I'm going to wolf down a hot dog at the airport. That's what he said.
Randi Rhodes, how much legs does this story have?
Well, as long as he tries to hold on to a Senate seat, people are going to take pot shots at him. Oh, see, everything's a double entendre. I don't even mean it to be that. But what the story just cracked us up today because of, you know, the hypocrisy of it all. And, you know, but truly, I just wanted to say this. Somewhere there is a 15-year-old kid struggling right now, being bullied in school because of his sexual orientation. And the whole idea that they still practice bigotry and that grand old pervert party, it's got to stop.
Lars, is that when she says something like that and you see about Senator Craig, is it embarrassing to you as a Republican?
No, because I don't think the grand old party stands for that. Randi Rhodes is trying to paint the rest of the Republican Party based on the actions of one individual, which
is crazy.
Well,
I don't want to ban on gay marriage, and I don't put those things on the ballot to get people
to vote. This isn't about gay marriage. It's about perverted sex in a bathroom.
The Republican Party plays every election.
Bathroom sex and gay marriage have nothing to do with each other, Randi.
Well, he's gay in the bathroom, Lars, and if the policy wasn't the way it was, he wouldn't.
Gay sex and gay marriage and sex in a bathroom.
You both are missing the big picture.
It's about the Republican policy
Randy,
that puts the man in the bathroom.
Okay. Well, she can't stop talking.
It's about the hypocrisy of a United States senator who went on Meet the Press and called Bill Clinton
a nasty,
dirty white boy, and he's doing the same things. Politicians have got to better start being responsible to themselves. And if you're not going to be responsible to yourself and to your family, then you have no business in public office. And this senator from Idaho has no business in public office because he is a great big hypocrite.
By the way, Larry,
the lesson, our Judge Mathis.
It isn't just one right-wing conservative family values advocate. We can go back once again to Ted Haggard, a leading evangelist who was a leader in the right-wing conservative movement. We then go to Mark Foley, same thing.
Foley's
family values guy. So we're not going to isolate this on one. We are proposing perhaps that is a culture within the Republican right-wing conservative movement of hypocrisy and contradiction.
Deny that, right?
Larry,
Lars,
here's the thing. When Republicans do bad things, I came out Monday night when this story broke in roll call and said, this guy has to go. And that's what Republicans do.
It's fully not
hold
this
on.
Guy.
Can you get Larry, can I get a word in edgewise with Randy?
Finish.
Mark Foley was out of the Congress so fast he packed his car and went back to Florida. This guy's going to be out before the end of the week. Where's William Jefferson? Where's the outrage at that kind of corruption? Apparently, the Democrats don't believe in calling their own on corruption. And bathroom sex has nothing to do with gay marriage. It's about corruption.
It's about the policies that the Republican Party stands for.
Not at all. Nobody's standing up for this guy. Nobody is standing up for this guy, Randi.
Stop making sex a sin,
and you'll keep
people out of the bathroom.
You wish we would, Randi, but we're not standing up for this guy.
We're going to hear a lot more on this. Thank you all very much.
This is what I don't understand.
Judge David Young, Randi Rhodes.
Thank you, Larry. It's been an entertaining experience.
Mathis, shut off the mics. Okay. Thank you, guests.